Hello everyone, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles. Today we are going to solve an even trios killer Sudoku created by Quarterthru, posted on the Logic Masters Germany portal. The Sudoku has been rated a staggering 97% so far on the portal, and many of the Sudokus by Quarterthru has excellent ratings over there. I will add the link to his Sudokus in the description of the video, and I will also add the online solving link for the Sudoku in the description. Please do try out the Sudokus, they are really excellent to solve. And before moving on to the rules, if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, please hit the subscribe button below. I would really appreciate if you subscribe to the channel. The rules are, normal Sudoku rules apply and normal killer Sudoku rules apply. That is, in cages, all the cells surrounded by dotted lines can't have repeating digits. All killer cages have an even total, so whatever cage you see in different colors will all have an even total. The next part is, the killer cages come in colored trios. These trios have the same total, so which means that, as you can see, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different colors, so all these colors will have the same total, and different colored cages must have a different total. Okay, so two colors, any two colors can't have the same total. So for example, if this is 8, this can't be 8, this would be something else, some other even digit total. And the last part of the rule is, dots show where consecutive digits appear within cages. Other consecutive digits may appear but not within cages. Okay, so inside the cages, as you can see, there are dots between some cells, which means that these two digits will be consecutive, right? And within the cages, if you don't have a dot, then the two adjacent cells cannot be consecutive. But outside, where there is no dot, they can be consecutive. But within the cage, all the cells surrounded by dotted lines, if you don't have a dot, then you can't have consecutive digits. So these are the rules. With that, we'll start solving this Sudoku. So the first thing to see is, if you have very long cages or very small cages, that will force any sum total or any digits. So as I see, there is a 5-digit cage here, which means that the minimum total is going to be 15, right? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5, but 15 is odd. So the minimum total is going to be 16. So which means that all the yellow cells will be minimum 16, and maximum, you have a 3-cell cage here, so the maximum can be reached only from this cage, which means that the maximum is 24, right? So the range of the yellow cage is from 16 to 24. This is a 16. Okay, I think we can reduce the values of the yellow cage further. If you have a 16 here, the maximum total that these three cells can take is a 15, right? This would be 1 and this would be 15. Then this digit can't possibly be anything to satisfy the total for the box, because in any row, column or a 3x3 box of Sudoku grid, the digit will always be, the sum total will always be 45, 1 plus 2 plus up to 9. So if you have a 16 as the possibility here, so this would be minimum, maximum 15. So 16 plus 15 would be 31, and this would have to be 14. So you can't have anything for value for that. So what will we do here is, we'll list out the possibilities for all the colors and see if we can go anything from there. So let us write the yellow possibilities first, each in the color, the blue color. So if you have yellow, so 16 is ruled out just now. Can we try with the 18? Can 18 be possible? If you have 18, this would be maximum 17. 18 plus 17 is 35, and you still can't have anything for the digit here. So 18 is also ruled out. So 20 is possible, I think. So 20, maximum 19. So this would be 6. So 20 is possible. And there is no problem with 22 and 24, I think, right? Because if this is a 24, this can be anything, 17, 16, and still satisfy the cage, right? No problem. So these are the possible values for the yellow cages. Let us move on to the other color. Maybe let us go in clockwise direction. So this color, what is this? Looks like black, maybe black. not really black, but let us go with the black. So the minimum sum is going to be 1 plus 2 plus 3, right? So minimum it is going to be 6. And maximum is defined by the shortest cage. So the shortest cage is of 2 cells long. So maximum it is going to be 7 plus 9, which is 16. But can it be 16? If you have 16, these two cells will be 7 plus 9. And again, these two cells would have to be 7 plus 9, which is not possible. So it is going to be 14. So the maximum is 14 and minimum is 16. 6, 8, 10. And 12, 14. So there is no other sum total that these cages can take, right? So can we reduce it any further? 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6. And this would be 1 plus 5 or 2 plus 4. And again, this would be 1 plus 5 or 2 plus 4. That doesn't seem to be anything for now. So let us move on to the next cage. So we'll quickly list out the possibilities for all the cages and then come back to see if we can reduce or do something further. So for the pink cage, the minimum total is going to be 6 again. And maximum is going to be 16, right? 7 plus 9. But I think we can reduce this further, right? So if you have 6 here, minimum 1 plus 2 plus 3. So how will you get the 6 total here? 6 needs to have 1 plus 5 or 2 plus 4, both of which are ruled out. So this can't be a 6. Can it be an 8? 8 is 1 plus 2 plus 5 or 1 plus 3 plus 4. So 8 seems to be possible, because the simplest way to see is if you group all these cells, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 6 will be 16. So 8 seems to be possible for now. And so the rest of the things are going to be possible. 8, 10, 12, 14 and 16, right? Let us look at the maximum sum. 16 is possible. 16 is ruled out, guys. So if you have 7 plus 9 here, you also need 7 plus 9 here. The same reason as this one. So 16 is ruled out. So maximum is 14. So 14 seems likely. So let us go to the red color now. The red cell can be minimum 6 is ruled out. 1 plus 2 plus 3. Again, you can't have 1 plus 2 plus 3 here. 6 is obviously ruled out. So this would be minimum 8. Can you have 8? 8, okay, 1, 2, 5. So 1 would have to be present in both the cages. So if you have a 1 here, the other one has to go here. And this can be 3, 4. And this would have to be 1, 2, 5. So 1, 2 and 5. Okay, it's possible. 8 is possible. Let us not explore further. We have to just look at the minimum and the maximum possibilities for the cages and see if we can eliminate further. 14, everything else is possible, right? 14 and 16. Maximum it can be only 16, guys, because maximum is defined by the shortest cage. So you have a 16 here, 7 plus 9, you can't have anything further. So red is from 8 to 16. So let us go to this color, orange. So minimum is defined by the longest cage. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, minimum is going to be 10. And maximum is defined by the shortest cage, so 16. So it can be anything from 10 to 16. 10 and 12 and 14 and 16 are the possibilities for the cages. So I don't think we can do anything further here, right? Of course, these sequence of dots are interesting, but without digits, I don't think they'll be much helpful now. So these are the possibilities for the orange cage. Let us go to the blue cage now. So blue is going to be minimum 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, minimum 10. And maximum it can be defined by the shortest cage, 16. So it can be 10, 12 or 14, 16. All these are possible. Can we reduce anything further? So can this be a 10? So if you have a 10, these two cells must sum up to 10. And these three cells must sum up to 10. Maximum you can get a 9 from these three cells. So 10 plus 10 plus 9 is 29. And you'll need 16 here. Not possible, right? Because the 3 by 3 box has to sum up to 45. So if you have a 10 here, this would be 10 and these 3 cells would be maximum 9. So 10 is ruled out. I think we can rule out 12 also for the same reason. 12 plus 12 is 24. So maximum you can get 11 here. So 24 plus 11 is 35 and you'll need a 10 here. So 12 is also ruled out. So blue has only 14 or 16. Is it possible to rule out further? you have a 16 here, 16 plus 16 is 32, and these four cells must add up to 13, which I think is possible. Can you have a 14? 14 plus 14 is 28, and this will be max 13. 28 plus 13 is 41. Yeah, this is possible, guys. Both of 14 and 16 are possible. So, have you written all the colors? 1, 2, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, one is missing. I think we have to write the green, right? Yeah. So, green is minimum. 6 is obviously ruled out because 2, 3 cages you have. 3 cell cages. So, 6 is ruled out. 8 is also ruled out because if you have a 3 cell cage, then you need to have a 1. But you have 2 3 cell cages. So, 8 is also ruled out. Can you have a 10? 10 is also ruled out, guys, because the minimum sum of these 6 cells is going to be 21, right? You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 1 plus up to 6 will give you minimum 21. And if you have a 10 here, then both of these cages will sum up to 20. So, 10 is also ruled out. So, you have minimum 12, maximum 16, defined by the longest, shortest cage, 7 plus 9. So, it can be anything from 12 to 16. So, we have written down all the possibilities here. So still we haven't made any progress on the Sudoku, and it's close to 10 minutes already. And we haven't made any progress on the Sudoku. What a tough Sudoku, right? But I think definitely there must be something, some information in the things that we have done so far. So if you look closely here, right, you see that almost all the cages are distributed between 6 to 16. So, except yellow, everything is between 6 to 16, right? So, let us look closely. Look at these 5 cages, guys. This is as good a global logic as you'll ever see. You'll ever see in any Sudoku. This is one of my favorite Sudokus that I've solved in the past 1 month or so. What an amazing piece of logic. So, pink, red, orange, blue and green can only take values between 8 to 16. So, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. So, which means that they are forming a pentuple of sorts. So, we are used to, we rarely see pentuples in Sudokus within the grid, but here you have pentuple for cage possibilities. So, all these 5 colors will have cage possibilities from 8 to 16, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. There is nothing else between these cages, right? So, which means that these 2 colors cannot have 8, 10, 12, 14, 16 possibility. So, for the blue, you can eliminate all the things except 6. Superb, guys. What a piece of construction by the author here. Amazing Sudoku. Really amazing Sudoku. So, we have got that the black has to be 6. So, we have got our start to the Sudoku now, which means that all the cages in the black colored cells will have sum total summing up to 6, which means that this will be 1 plus 2 plus 3, right? We can quickly write that. So, these 2 cells are consecutive, which means 2 must be here, right? So, this is not a 2, so this is 1, 3. And these 2 cells don't have a white dot between them, which means they are not consecutive. So, remember that the last part of the rule is that within cages, you can have consecutive digits only if they are separated by a white dot. So, this is not a 2, so which means that this will be a 2. And this will be 1, 3. Which means that for this 6 cage, it would have to be 1, 5, 1 plus 5, 2 plus 4 is ruled out. And this cage cannot be 1 plus 5 now, because 1, 5 is here. So, this will be 2, 4. So, a 1, 3 possibility removes the 1 from here. So, this is 5, this is 1. Okay, now we have filled in the black cages. Black is not going to help us anymore. So, let us probe further among these possibilities. If you look closer, pink and red are the only colors which can take an 8. These 5 colors form a pentuple of sorts. But out of which, pink and red can only have the possibility of 8. So, one of these 2 must take an 8. Let us see which one has to take the 8. So, this pink is helping us now because we have placed the 1 and 2 here. So, if it is 8, the pink is 8, so this will be 3, 5, right? And now this 3 cell cage also needs to sum up to 8, which means it has to be 1 plus 2 plus 5, not possible, or 1 plus 3 plus 4, again not possible. So both the possibilities are ruled out. So pink cannot be 8. So pink is not 8. Pink is 10, 12 or 14. Which means that the red has to be 8. No other color can be 8. Right? So red has to be 8. Amazing Sudoku, guys. One of the best I've solved in the past few months. Really good. So the red is 8. So which means that the 1 has to be present in this cage, but 1 cannot be in row 3, column 9. So which means 1 has to be here. So this would have to be 1, 2. And we know that the 3 cell cage also needs to contain 1 because of the 8. So this will be 1 because 1 can't be here. And this gives a 2 and a 1 here. And now this has to be sum up to 8. So this would be 5. And this would be cannot be 1 plus 2 plus 5. So this would be 1 plus 3 plus 4. And we satisfy the consecutive part as well. Okay. So we've got the red cage. 1 is pending. So this can be 6, 7, 8 or 9. 8 and 9 are ruled out because sum is 8. This would be 6 and 7 and this would be 2 and 1 correspondingly. Right. So let us continue the Sudoku further. I think the pink is going to help us now because we have placed the 1. The minimum sum is going to get more, right? So if you look further, only pink or orange can be 10. So look how systematically the Sudoku is progressing, guys. We got the 6 first, we got the 8 next, and now I think we should be getting the 10. So pink or orange is 10. Either orange is 10 or pink is 10. But if you look at the pink, because 1 is here, so to have the 10 total, this would have to be 2, 3, 5. If you don't have a 1 in a 3 cell cage, the minimum, the possibilities would have to be 2 plus 3 plus 5 in a 3 cell cage. Now, can this be 10? 1 plus 9 is ruled out. 2 plus 8 is ruled out. 3 plus 7 is ruled out. And 4 plus 6 is also ruled out. So, you can't have a 10 possibility for the pink cage. Superb, guys. Amazing Sudoku. So, this would be 12 or 14. And now, orange has to take the 10 because no other cage has a 10. Right, so orange would have to be 10. So I think we can focus on orange for now. So 4 cell cage, and if you have a 10, they must be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. Out of which you have 3 consecutive digits, which means they are 1, 2, 3 or 2, 3, 4. Right, is it possible to deduce that? So if you have 1, 2, 3, so because of 1 here, so this will be 1, this will be 2, this will be 3. Why don't we write the possibilities? And this would be 4. I don't see any problem with this. If you have 2, 3, 4 inside the cage because of the 2 here, so this will be 2, this will be 3, and this would be 4. And the 1 has to go here. Okay, you can't have a 1 because of the classic rule here, right? 1 can't be here, so which means that this would have to be a 4. And correspondingly, these 3 cells would have to be 1, 2, 3 now. 1, 2, and 3. And now these 2 cells must sum up to 10. Without the 1, 2, 3, they would have to be 4, 6. And so this cage also sums up to 10, which means that you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, so 5, 7, 8, and 9. But 8 and 9 are ruled out, right? You can't have a 10 total with 8 and 9 inside them in a 3 cell cage. So this is 5 or 7. Oh, you have a 2 here, right? Which means you can place the 1 here. So this is 1, this is 7. And this 1 gives us a 1 and a 3 here, right? Okay, this 7 gives us a 5 here, which means these 2 cells must sum up to 5 and they must be consecutive. So 1 plus 4 or 2 plus 3. 1 plus 4 is not possible because you have a white dot, so which means 2, 3 is the option. But you have a 2 here, so which means you get the 2 here and this would be 3. And that resolves this 3-4 pair, which in turn resolves this 4-6 pair. Superb, guys. What a Sudoku, guys. I can't stop appreciating the Sudoku. The logic which the author had tried to incorporate here. 1, 4, 7, 2, 3, 5, 6. So remaining possibilities are 8, 9. So where do we continue now? Let us look at the blue cage. It's severely restrained now. You see that the blue cage is distributed over box 8 and you've got one more digit. So obviously it should help. So blue has only two possibilities, 14 or 16. Is a 14 possible? So if you have 14, these 2 cells sum up to 14. These 3 cells sum up to 14. So 14 plus 14 is 28. Plus 4 is 32, and you must have balanced 13 from these cells, which means that this cell has to be a 1, but 1 is ruled out. Amazing. So which means that it can't be a 14, so this would have to be a 16. Now I think we can get the digit here. So these two cells must sum up to 16, which means they are 7, 9 in some order. And these cells sum up to 16. 16 plus 16 is 32. 32 plus 4 is 36. And you will have 9 from these three cells, which means that for the 16, you need to have a 7 here. Superb. And these two cells must be 8 and 9. Okay. So these three cells sum up to 9 without the 4. That should give you some idea. So which means they are either 1 plus 3 plus 5 or 1 plus 2 plus 6. In both the cases, you have 1 as the common logic, but and 1 is here. So which means that this would be a 1. This is either 3, 5 or 2, 6. But 5 is here, so which means 5 is ruled out from here. Which means correspondingly 3 is ruled out from here, and you have a 6 here, so 6 is ruled out, and correspondingly 2 is ruled out. So 1, 3, 5, and 1, 2, and 6. So 8 would have to go in these 3 cages, 3 cells. Not helping us. So let us look at row 9 now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 9. So remaining possibilities are 5, 6, and 8, and these two are consecutive, so which means that this will be 5, 6, and this will be 8. I think yellow cells now should help because we have 3 possibilities. So yellow can be 20, 22 or 24. But 20 is ruled out, right? Because 5 plus 6 plus 8 is 19. And you can't have a sum of 1 from 2 cages. So it is 22 or 24. 22 or 24. If you have 22, these two cells must sum up to 3. You will have 1, 2 as the possible options. Because 1 is here, and if you have 24, these 3 cells sum up to 19, you must have 5 from these 2 cells, which and they are also consecutive. So only option is 2 plus 3, right? 1 plus 4 is not possible, so 2 plus 3. So in both the cases, you see that there is a 2 here, 1 plus 2 or 2 plus 3, which means that this is not a 2. This is 4 and this is 2. Superb. We haven't yet able to deduce the pink and the yellow, right? Green is 10, 12, 14 or 16. Okay, green is also giving us a lot of options. So how do we continue here? So we know that the yellow cell is either 22 or 24. In both the cases, you must have at least a 9 in the cage. You must have a 9 in this cage. Because without the 9, 22 and 24 are not possible. So okay, I'm seeing a digit which we can place using classic rule. So 1 plus 1, you have 1 in row 4 and row 5, right? So 1 must be in these 3 cells, but 1 cannot go in column 5 and column 6. So which means this will be a 1. And now I think the green cells are becoming constrained because 1 is outside. So let us see the possibilities now. Can it be a 12 here? If you have a 12, so these 6 cells must sum up to 24, 12 into 2. And from these 3 cells, you must have 21 total to satisfy the box total of 45. Row 4 column 6, row 5 column 6, and row 6 column 4 must sum up to 21 with the 1 in them. Not possible, right? So 12 is ruled out. This is 14 or 16. Can you have a 14? 14 plus 14 is 28, and these 3 cells must sum up to 17 now with the 1. So this will be 7, 9. I think that is possible. 14 is possible, guys. And you have a 16. You have 16. 16 plus 16 is 32 plus 1, 33. And these two cells must sum up to 12. 16 also seems likely. So green can be 14 and 16. Oh, we have got the blue as 16, right? So green cannot be 16. We need not have tried that. So this will be 14, this will be 16, which means that the pink has to be 12. because we formed a pentacle, if you remember, from these colors. So it can't be 14, 16. So this is 12. Now red we have deduced already, it is 8, right? So I think we can use this now. Let us use for the green. Green is 14. So 14 plus 14, 28, 29. These two cells must sum up to 16, 7, 9. And since you have a 14 here, you can't have 7 here. So this will be a 9. This will be a 5, which means this is 8. This is 9. And using classic rule, you get the 4 here. These two cells must be 6 and 8. Right? And which means this is a 9. Classic rule, this is 8. And we are getting quick digits now. Oh, beautiful, guys. You can't have 9 here because 9 is here. And you also can't have 9 here because that would force the 8 here and you have an 8 here. So which means this is not 9, so this is 9. So for the 24 cage, you have 8 here and 7 here. And for the 22, you have 5 plus 8 is ruled out because 5 is here. And 6 plus 7 are the possibilities. So 6, 7, 6, 7. These are the only options possible here. Because 22 is 5 plus 8 plus 9 or 6 plus 7 plus 9. Because you got a 9 here, so this will be a 7. And we know that the pink is 12 now, so it can't be 4 plus 8, can't be 5 plus 7, so it has to be 3 plus 9. And this cage can't be 3, 9, 4, 8, so it would have to be 5, 7. You have the 5 here, so this would be 7, this would be 5. This sums up to 12 as well. 1 plus 5 is 6, plus 12 is 18, plus 12 is 30, and you need 15 from this cage without the 9, so which is 7 and 8. This can't be 7, so this would have to be 8, this would have to be 7. And that resolves the 6 8 pair immediately. This is 8 and 6. This must be 2, 4, 6. You have a 2, 4 here, so this is 6. Means this will be 2, 4. And you have a 4 here, which means this is 4, this is 2. And this 2 gives a 5 here. And this must be a 3 to satisfy the 16 total in this cage. Superb, guys. We are getting the digits very fast now. So a 7 here resolves this 7, 9 pair. And which in turn resolves this 3-9 pair. And now the remaining digits in row 2 are 8 and 9. So a 9 here gives the 8 here and 9 here. Which means that we know that this cage can't be 24 anymore. So this would have to be a 22 and this would have to be a 6-7. And 6-7 pair gives 5 here. This is 5. This is 6. And these 3 digits must be 3-5-6. 5 is in column 1 and column 3, so 5 is here and this will be 3, 6. So you have a 6, 7 pair here, so this is 3 and this is 6, right? And because of the 3 here, you get the 2 here and the 1 here. And these two cells now must be 4 plus 8, sorry, 4 and 8, because 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7 and 9. And an 8 here gives the 8 here and the 4 here. And these two cells must be 3 and 9, right? So the 3 here gives the 9 here and a 3 here. And this must be 4 and 7 is 7 here. So 7 and 4. And if you add all these cages, you must get a 22, which I hope. 12 plus 7, 19, and you are getting 22. So which means we are on the right track. So 1, 3, 5, 4, 7, 9. Remaining digits are 2, 6, 8. You have 8 here. So this is 8. Means that this must be 2, 6. 6 here gives the 6 here and the 2 here. A 7 here gives the 7 and 6 here. And these two cells must be 2 and 4. You have the 4 here. So this is 4, this is 2. Green sums to 14. So 2 plus 4 is 6. It would have to be 8. This would have to be 3, 5 and 6. Out of which these two cells are consecutive. So this would have to be 5, 6. And this would have to be a 3. And 6 resolves the 6, 5, 6 pair. And now we have only 3 digits left. 1, 3, 8, 2, 4, 5. 6, 7 and 9. You have 7 in row 4 and row 5. So this would have to be a 7. This is a 6 and this is a 9. And with that, we have completed one of the best Sudokus ever created. It is not an exaggeration by any means of any stretch of imagination. It was an amazing Sudoku. The global logic is what really drove the Sudoku. Without the global logic, I seriously doubt if we will ever be able to place even one digit. So we formed a pentacle of sorts between the five of the colors. They took the values 8 to 16, right? 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, which in turn gave the value of the black color, right? As 6. And with that, we started the Sudoku. This was an amazing global logic to incorporate in a Sudoku. We thank Quarterthru for creating a Sudoku and for giving us the permission to solve this Sudoku. Hope you guys enjoyed watching me solve this brilliant creation. We hope to enthrall you with many more such creations in the future. Stay tuned until then. Take care. Bye-bye.